current political times when people have been vilified because of their classification within society, I think that undocumented immigrants have faced a great deal of harsh rhetoric, you know, regarding their being here in the community. The reason that I first put this idea out there was that Maplewood can ensure that those who are undocumented immigrants can feel safe when they're here in Maplewood. When I say feel safe, I don't mean above the law or able to engage in criminal behavior. I mean that when in Maplewood, there are not going to be township resources used to question them about their immigration status here in the United States. We've thrown around a lot of ideas since we started talking about this, I guess it's 2 weeks ago, and Mayor Lincoln has done quite a bit of research and spoken with other towns and cities in the country that have put such ordinances and resolutions into place, has done quite a bit of research with the New Jersey Attorney General's office, and he is really kind of taking the lead and done a great job with this. We'll just turn it over to him to talk about some of the things that he's come up with to try to address what some people's concerns are.
And thank you. We had a meeting with the police chief. We share all the information with the chief city. We had a meeting with him last Wednesday, and he drafted something too. And we had a very spirited and good conversation about different scenarios, and I think
that
that's good. And I sent him this thing that I revised today, and he indicated that we were moving in the right direction, and that he was, I haven't checked every word with him, but I think he was comfortable with it. I think we felt, and Ms. Larry, you can talk about this. We felt the way to move this was through a resolution as opposed to an ordinance. An ordinance is a little more cumbersome to change. A resolution expresses our point of view and it allows us to modify it as the dynamics take place next year and the year after. And it would still hold up, you know, we would be able to direct departments and employees the same way. Essentially what it says is that, you know, no one in the town can deny anyone benefits or services based on their citizenship or immigration status. It says that we're all going to uphold the Constitution. We're not going to take any action to profile anyone. We're not going to engage in racially influenced policing. It says that we will not take part in any registration or reporting of individuals based on religion. So any registries that come up, we will not participate. It talks about the police department and its mission being to enforce state and local criminal laws and protect the community it serves, and it does not administer federal immigration laws. And then it talks about that the police department won't stop, question, arrest, detain, or initiate investigations of any individual's immigration status for the sole and singular purpose of conducting enforcement of federal immigration laws. And then talks about how the police will adhere to the directives and guidelines of the Attorney General with respect to the manner in which local law enforcement agencies interact with federal immigration authorities. We're not going to break the law, we have to follow the law. That we're not going to expend township resources or funds to enforce federal immigration laws. It talks about 45 days after passage. He asked that it would be 90 days after passage because he wants to check with the prosecutor's office and the attorney general's office to do the policies. So that 90 days after passage, the chief will develop